Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Braden Books. If you are new here, go ahead, click the subscribe button, ring that bell. 100 more subscribers since the last video. Keep it coming. I love it. I love your comments. Some amazing comments. If you have not seen any of my previous Bridgerton reactions, welcome. Hello. It's all fun and games here. We're not going to take things too seriously. We're not doing brain surgery. None of that. We're talking about thirsty men on a Shonda Rhimes show. Practice your Anthony Flex, grab your beverage, and I'll wait here. Let's jump into Bridgerton, episode 5, season 1. And if kids are watching, I hope kids aren't watching my channel. Oh my goodness. I talk about dick on this channel so much. Oh, this is what we call in the business a quick change. When you're playing hooky. I don't feel good today. Such a liar.
I did not overindulge.
You did.
I'm engaged.
Ha
Oh, you will be a princess. No.
No.
No, I will not. Mama, I'm engaged to the Duke.
What? I'm confused. You were just telling me this was all a ruse.
I knew there was something between you. Ruse or not.
Take a shot.
Tell me everything.
Even your father and I, we had trouble controlling our passions as well.
I don't want to see that. Jeffree Star scene in his Hidden Hills mansion. Didn't he move to Wyoming? Not because of the fracking.
I have nothing to be sorry for. No promises were made.
Oh, baby boy.
The fault is mine for misreading your polite attentions is something more.
You ship that royal package over here. Sunday in the park with
Daphne.
Well, do not make haste on our account.
Ooh, look at that royal purple.
Did you bring the bar with you, boy?
Oh, my Simon. He's walking funny. He's got the vapors.
I should.
Did you say?
I was going to ask if you'd tried drinking.
Friggin' print ad.
It isn't the most talked about couple in the Tom.
Who's this homo? Is that Hans?
We are so happy.
Very much so.
Yes, you look so happy. It's like when we see Melania.
I love the children.
Madame Delacroix, good day. May I?
She's not here.
I only take a moment of my time.
Why are you shouting? You're literally a foot away from her. Indoor voices.
This is the library.
Snap.
You gonna make him cry again?
Miss Thompson, I bring you flowers on each of my visits, and yet you react with admirable surprise every-
Dairy girl on the outside, dairy girl on the inside.
Marina hates tomatoes.
That is untrue.
The insecurity is creeping out. The green monster has reared its ugly head, and it is coming to get her. Shit.
Perhaps you could bring back a tomato plant for Miss Thompson as a souvenir when you return from your travels this year.
I am.
She's acting like a little brat. She's just in love.
Uncertain of my travels at the moment, then.
But you are so keen to travel.
It is true. But
nobody wants a friend like that. You don't want to be the cock block, dude. You don't want to. She's pulling an Anthony. Oh no.
What could I possibly need with 5 new nightdresses?
Fucking.
Mama. Might you spare me a moment? I must have Cressida's opinion on some fabric.
AKA, gotta set a bitch straight.
Well, at this time of year. Well, I suppose it depends on how much time you and the Duke spend outdoors. But you are fond of a midnight garden stroll, I believe.
They are. Practically every episode, actually. Cressida.
I do not know what you mean. I saw the two of you in the garden.
This director was like, we're getting shots. They're gonna be so cinematic. They're gonna be so juicy. They're gonna be so delicious. 100% fresh.
Trowbridge ball. No chaperone in sight.
Oh my goodness. Nobody minds their effing business in this town.
I have come to bid you farewell, Tanta. I shall be returning to Prussia this afternoon.
Because of sauerkraut.
Hastings is merely a duke. You are a prince.
I have before the young lady, nor do I need to.
Who is the bigger dick, though?
I am happy for that.
Auf Wiedersehen, if you must go. While you may be content to accept defeat, it is certainly not how I approach things.
Anthony's in a church? I'm surprised he's not burning.
Apologies for my tardiness. Not at all.
The Archbishop has yet to arrive.
Ooh.
We're getting juicy.
I'm being quiet because we're in the church. You know what I mean? Daphne's dowry.
I must apologize for, well, shooting at me. Indeed.
Literally, at the chest. I also want to say that after reading all the comments and stuff, I do fully realize that I have basically put all of my gay fantasies onto what's actually happening. So now I'm going to actually attempt to see the story from the writer's perspective. So they clearly, there's none of that simmering was actually happening. I understand. It just makes me so sad.
Express my gratitude for your granting of this special license.
Perhaps, my lord, you should not.
That's rude.
What on earth for?
For some reason, the Archbishop of Canterbury did not think he owed me an explanation.
Antony's hair looks so right there.
It is not the Archbishop. It is the Queen. Perhaps she's taken your rejection of her nephew to heart.
Be able to do something.
Oh, look at him. I just love these sideburns so much. They're royally satisfying. This hair is so coiffed.
Give her what she wants. Attention. Appear before her yourselves and make a personal appeal.
She is the goat, man. Greatest of all time. I'm not calling her an actual goat. That would be rude.
Where is the dinner I was promised?
Me. I came for the food. He's back.
Make yourself at home. I would show you around, but most duty calls.
Now, this seems like it's evolved past a nude drawing to something a little more horny. Oh, very Suspiria. That movie is freaky, truly. And then in the remake, Tilda Swinton, oh man. Let's not forget that there was a period in time where Tilda Swinton was in a museum in New York. Was it the MoMA? I forget, but she was in a museum and it was an installation where she was in a glass box and she just napped and people would watch her and take photos. Wow.
It's time for an orgy.
Okay, it's not much, but I'll take it. No! Maybe he wanted him to join, maybe he wasn't ready yet? There is always like a process to getting comfortable in an orgy. You know what I mean? Comment down below what you do at your orgies. Okay, we're doing that. We're denying our homosexuality? Yeah, okay. I did that. I, believe it or not, dated women. I think 4 women. Once, one every year in high school. I tried it. I did a little here, a little that, a little diddling myself. And then finally got to a point where I saw a penis and I said I like it.
Is that how the tune goes?
These two. I'd also watch that.
Is this about Mr. Bridgerton? He likes me.
It's always about a man.
If I were to marry Mr. Bridgerton, you would be connected to what I gather is a very powerful family indeed. Think what that could do for your girls.
What about that?
That is only assuming we wait until the wedding night to consummate the union. You will seduce him. I will do what I must.
Instantly takes me back to The Little Mermaid, that scene where Ariel's lost her voice and Vanessa took it, and then they're like down talking to the priest or whatever. They're like, we have to get married. And she's sitting there like, that's this.
Your subjects miss you, my dear. I miss you.
Yeah, where have you been?
Have you done something? What have you done?
Oh, this is a very sad situation now.
Time to touch myself again.
Rose, is everything all right?
You're not the Duke.
You are not who I worry about.
Who do you worry about?
The Duke.
Oh.
You smell bad.
Very reminiscent of...
We hate Uncle Jamie.
Wow, that's the second time I've referenced Love Actually on this channel so soon. Are you in the camp of people who love it or think it's overhyped? I love it. I'm that bitch. Call me Cheryl because I'm loving Love Actually.
In your gut. Eat.
That doesn't look like the most appetizing. I'd be like, I'm good.
Good.
Have you told the Duke about your exhibition series business?
Alice?
Will is seeking more investors for a series of matches. Perhaps, Your Grace, you and your future brother-in-law might be interested in investing.
The women of Bridgerton getting shit done, thinking like a business person.
Right, dears, come on.
Child actors, man. They're probably twins. Most child actors working are twins. Is that an accurate statement to make? I don't think so. I personally prefer the royal corgi. I had a corgi named Rocky. He was so cute.
As low as you can go, Lady Danbury.
With these knees? Yes, Your Majesty.
How dare she? Do you see her? She is a cane. Be nice.
Very well.
That wig's phenomenal.
You see, Your Majesty, it was love at first sight.
It was not, Your Majesty. You see, Miss Bridgerton and I have been fooling all of Mayfair for quite some time. We have fooled them into thinking we are courting.
What is this? Simon's being honest?
And really, all along, we simply enjoyed each other's company so much we could not stay away from one another. I had never been a man that much enjoyed flirting, or chatting, or indeed talking at all.
Same. And then you get to a point where you're like, I deserve more. Like, my body is worth something. It is a temple. I should preserve it, and I should share it with someone who gives a fuck about me. Because sex, easy to find. I'll give you the task. Try to find a decent man in Los Angeles.
To meet a beautiful woman is one thing, but to meet your best friend and the most beautiful of women is something entirely apart.
Yes, get rid of those abandonment issues. Shed them. Super Soul Sunday it.
Perhaps unusually lucky to understand friendship to be the best possible foundation a marriage can have. I shall like to offer you the choice, Miss Bridgerton. Do you wish to marry this man?
Do it. Do it, girl, do it. Don't you let me down, girl.
He's so sad in the face because he's not marrying Anthony. Sorry, I can't help myself. Not this revolving nauseous. Ugh. I love how they still are like, we're gonna sneak in some Grey's Anatomy type alt music into this Bridgerton marriage scene.
What about him? He seems pleasant.
She's like, you're an awful friend. What's going on here?
Oh, him. Kind eyes.
Honestly, look at that choice of on, motherfucker. I have dated boys that look like this. Twinks in the building.
Ken, I neither know nor have time for any of these men. Now, where is Colin?
You can choose anyone but him.
You have a condition.
Well, should I perhaps entrap a bad man then?
Don't you hate it when your insecurities get the best of you? And instead of just having that honest interaction of saying, I was hurt because I had feelings and blah, 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 you complicate it.
Oh! I should.
Make it nice. Make it nice.
I'm beginning to feel a little bit faint. Perhaps you know of a more private place where I might catch my breath?
Certainly.
We love a confident person who actually puts themselves first. She's so beautiful. What do I say more on this channel? Daddy or she's so beautiful? Clearly it's daddy.
We should not be alone in here.
No, we should not. I can hardly believe I'm saying this, but we cannot go further.
We stand a respectful man.
Then marry me. I know we have only known each other a short while, but...
That was such a 180 so quickly, sir. So it's typically about this point of the evening when I'm filming that my camera dies, which it did. So while that was charging, I ordered some Indian food, which is on the way. I treated myself, and we're gonna get back into this. So that by the time my chicken tikka masala comes, they're boinking. We do enjoy the hair evolution of our queen.
Yes. You certainly enjoy spreading secrets, do you not? Dear child, have you lost your wits? Everyone enjoys secrets. Otherwise, why would Lady Whistledown's paper be so successful?
It's so true. I make fun of all of this drama, but at the end of the day, still watching it, still doing reactions and posting them online. So yeah, I guess you could say I'm still interested. Gossip, man.
Ah, dearest. I believe you know Mr. Bridgerton. My wife. Mrs. Lucy Granville. He refused for your benefit, sister. I shall put the money in trust so you may use it how you see fit.
I've always been so jelly of people who are born with trust funds. Like, damn.
I suppose I have put this conversation off for as long as I can.
The birds and the bees. I don't think I actually had, like, that kind of conversation with my parents. I actually think I had to go to a health fair. I went to a Catholic school at that time, and that health fair was just the worst. I feel like I was so embarrassed I was sick the next day. But I went with my dad, and when the priest, like, told us all to say a prayer for our blossoming bodies, I don't recommend that either. That's not fun for anybody. Oh my god, what's, like, the worst food to eat before that you should never? I'd say Chipotle is pretty bad. Like, I don't know about you, but every time, Chipotle and I have a love and a hate relationship because it really is abusive, because usually it does that to my intestinal tract because I eat it so quickly.
The marital act, which now that you are married, you may perform. I still have so many questions, Mama.
Why don't you just experience it for yourself? You know, it's like going to a Benihana for the first time. You know, you just have to experience it yourself.
What?
They are bringing the carriages around. It is time.
You're gonna get a royal pounding. When royals are embarrassed, they just cover themselves with half their fan.
I know we cannot be any more different, but there is one thing we do share. The certainty that you will make your own way in this world. I'm sure of it, Eloise.
Women lifting up women. Tell me when he enters. Tell me everything. Is this where I am to be deflowered?
Your room of grace is just over here.
I requested a separate room.
No! Dick o'clock, as I call it.
We should go down to dinner.
Oh god, don't make me say it, but I think I know what's on the menu. Disgusting. My Indian food game.
You have avoided my presence.
In order to allow you your liberty.
You've said all but a few words to me.
In order to keep myself from saying the wrong things. I am yours, Daphne. I have always been yours.
The Duke was very vulnerable and he said, these are my feelings.
You're downright flush.
Yes, that is what happens.
When one is angry.
When one burns for someone who does not feel the same.
I burn for you.
They burn for each other.
You won't stop.
Mm-hmm. Show us more. Titty check. Ab check. Okay. I knew they weren't gonna make it to dinner.
Did you touch yourself? Like we talked about.
The Duke likes dirty talk. Okay, Daddy. Was that really his ball sack? I gotta see a man about something. Okay, I see a bulge or something of some sort, but... That was like a, ooh, oh, this might hurt face.
This may hurt a moment.
Uh-huh. Daphne grunts, moans, sounds about right. That's right. The director is giving you shots, mama. Thought he was having a heart attack. The man just came. Did he shoot to the side? Damn, Daphne. You just got deflowered. That was pretty hot. The lighting was fantastic. 3 full episodes left to see how this is gonna continue. A lot of it was spent on the Duke as well as Daphne. They fought. It seems like they're fully falling for each other. And Duke is being vulnerable, which we know he doesn't do very often. Daphne is being vulnerable. They're being honest and open. Everything that you should do in a relationship. So that's good on that front. She got hers. Apparently, I say this every episode. Apparently episode 7? No, 6 is the big sting. That's where it really goes off. So a little bit here. That was fun and all, but I mean, I'm a little thirsty still. But anyway, I mean, when all is said and done, we saw a nice little shot of Simon's booty, maybe his balls, we don't know, but either way, thank you, Shonda Rhimes. Until next time, friends, stay safe.